Ayan, so hello, grade 8. Ayan, so this will be our lecture on chapter 3 or lesson number 3 about our topic. Okay? So, ayan, so for chapter 3 or lesson number 3, we will be talking about sound waves. Okay? So, when we have sound waves, ayan, paano nga ba tayo muna nakakapag-produce ng sound? Diba? So, ano nakikita nyo? Diba may mga sumasayaw, nakikinig ng music? Diba? So, sino dito yung mga mahilig kumanta? Yan. Okay. So, bale, paano nga ba naririnig yung boses ko? Paano ba naririnig? Or paano ba, tawag dito? Paano ba tayo nakakapagpakinig ng music? Ayan. So, syempre, ayan, paano nga ba nakakakanta ang isang artist or ang isang singer, 'di ba? So, ayun. Medyo nakakahiya pero sampulan ko kayo. Satin-satin lang 'to, ha, grade 8. Ayan. So, paano nga ba? Tatanggo na ako tapos. Huwag na ipaalam sa iba. Ayan, sige. Ayan, kakantahin ko ano, kay Moira. Tagu-taguan. Ayan. So, after ko mag-sample, dapat kayo din, ha? Isend nyo na lang sa akin sa messenger ko. Sino man ang matapang na mag-send sa akin ng voice recording ng kanta. Kahit chorus lang sa messenger, makakatanggap ng 3 bonus points sa quiz na darating. Okay? Clear ba yan, ha? Pag kayo hindi nag-send, nako, wala kayong bonus points. Sa mag-send kayo ng voice record sa akin sa messenger, ako lang naman makakarinig, walang iba. Okay? Ito na, mauuna ako. Para naman hindi kayo mahiya at may mag-send sa akin ng ano, sample. Diba? Ayan.
Tagu-taguan, maliwanag ang buwan, masarap magmahal. Pag hindi iniwan, magbilang...
Pumiyok pa ako. Ulit.
Tagu-taguan, maliwanag ang buwan, masarap magmahal. Pag hindi iniwan, magbilang kung tatlo nakatahon na ako, ibalik ako sa nakaraan.
Ayan, tama na. Basta ha, wait, ha? Legit yun ha, pag mag-send sa akin ng voice recording ng kahit anong chorus ng kahit anong kanta, makakakuha sa akin ng bonus points sa quiz. Ha? Ayan, tapangan nyo na lang. Ita-take note ko sa notebook ko kung sino man yung mga magsesend. At pag nag-quiz kayo, i-add ko na lang yun. Ayan. Anyway, ayan. So, tao, kaya tayo naririnig yung boses natin kasi there is a vibration. Okay, so ano ba ang nagva-vibrate sa atin? It's found here in our vocal cords. So the vocal cords vibrate. So that's why you can hear a sound. Okay, that's why you can actually hear my voice right now because while I am speaking, my vocal cords are vibrating so that you can hear my voice while I am lecturing to you. Okay? So, let us discuss about the production and transmission of sound waves. So, first, let us define what sound is. So, sound is a type of wave. So, it travels in the forms of waves. So, meron tayong dalawang klase ng waves dito. First, you have the longitudinal wave. So, sound is considered as a longitudinal wave that is created by vibrating objects. So, when you vibrate an object, or let's say, aside from our voice, we can also produce a sound when we use musical instruments like a guitar. O, sino yung mga nagigitara dyan? Yan. Okay? So, yan. Ano yung ginagalaw natin sa gitara para magkaroon siya ng sound? Di ba yung string? Di ba you're going to pluck the string of a guitar? And once you pluck it, it's going to vibrate. Diba? So magkakaroon ng parang ganun-ganun-ganun yung string ng guitar. Okay? So, when a vibrating object is present, a longitudinal wave is created, and that longitudinal wave is sound. So, bali yung sound, that is a longitudinal wave. And sound is also a mechanical wave because it requires a medium to propagate. So, when you say medium, it can be any solid, liquid, or gas. So, medium, yun yung kung saan nagtatravel yung sound natin. Okay? So, next. Yan. So, it is composed of waves of compression and rarefaction that carries energy. So, sound doesn't really transport the particles that is where it is traveling through. It is only transferring energy. So, if you recall from our previous lesson wherein I discussed energy, parang napahapyawan ko na na yung energy, nagta-travel yun, di ba? So, in this case, the energy, the sound energy in this specific case is transported by the medium or the solid, the liquid, or the gas where it is traveling through. Okay? And it is also called a pressure wave. So, ngayon, i-discuss natin ngayon specifically kung ano nga ba yung longitudinal, yung tawag dito. Mamaya, i-discuss natin kung ano yung mga longitudinal waves. Pero, let's discuss first about the sound propagation. So, di ba nga, nabanggit po kanina na meron tayong solid, liquid, and gas. So, as you can see here, solid is the one at the left, liquid is the one in the middle, and gas is the one at the right side. So, I know that you already know this from last year because this was discussed. So, as you can see, the particles in solid are more closer together. In liquid, they are sliding past one another. And for gas, we have the particles that are passing through each other. So, they're not really close to each other. Okay, so paano nga ba nagpo-propagate ang sound? Okay, so sound propagates through those medium. And yung ibig sabihin ng medium, that is a means to carry sound. So, since a mechanical wave needs a medium, so when there is no medium to travel through, then sound cannot travel. Okay, so imagine yourself, you are in outer space, and then you try to shout. Kunwari, wala tayong spacesuit at tawag dito, walang spacesuit, tapos kunwari, kaya nating makasurvive ng walang suot na spacesuit sa outer space. In outer space, when you shout, or if you try to speak, or you try to communicate, no one can actually hear you. Why? Because outer space is a vacuum. Again, a vacuum. Ano nga ba yung vacuum? So, vacuum is a space wherein there is no matter. There is no medium. So, walang particles kung saan pwede mag-travel yung sound. So, that's why when you shout, when you're in outer space, no one can actually hear you because the sound energy cannot be transferred from one particle to another. Kasi yung vibration ng sound, yun yung nagta-transport. Okay, so for example, you have two particles here. So this one vibrates. And then this vibration is passed to the second particle. So that's how sound travels. The vibration is transferred from one particle to another. Okay? So clear ba yun? Ayan. So, sound travels at different speed based on the medium where it passes by. So, later on next week, you're going to have an activity wherein you're going to do, wherein you're going to see and find out which among these three medium or three media rather na where sound travels the fastest. Okay, so, but I guess you can get a glimpse of the answer through our later discussions. Okay? So, now that we know that sound can travel at different speeds, and so there are different And so let's talk about the speed of sound. So sabi ko nga kanina, aaralin natin or i-recall natin kung ano ba yung longitudinal wave. So a longitudinal wave is a wave in which each particle moves parallel to the direction of the wave motion. As you can see in the picture here below, the wave is moving in this direction to the right. So kung parallel yung kung parallel yung movement ng particles natin, so parang nagpo-push and pull lang siya. Okay, so meron longitudinal waves occur when there is a push and pull on the particles. So since meron tayong push and pull, so we have what you call compressions and rarefactions. So I think this is just a recall of your grade 7 topics. So a compression is a region that is pressed together, and as you can see here, it is labeled as color blue, and that is the part of the longitudinal wave wherein you can see that the waves are closer together. So yung darker part, that's where the compression is found, because the particles are closer together, that's why it is a bit darker compared to the other parts of the wave. And then next is we have a rarefaction. So that is the region that is spread apart. So yan yung hiwa-hiwalay. Compression, magkakadikit. Rarefaction, magkakahiwalay. Okay? Nagets ba yun? Yan. So the rarefactions are the ones, is the one rather, that is labeled grand. So your rarefaction, that is where the particles are farther apart. Since they are farther apart, hindi siya ganun ka-itin yung kulay kasi magkakalayo yung mga particles. Okay? So, ito yung ating longitudinal wave. Ayan. So, now, when we're going to be specific in sound, so, what you see here is a tuning fork. So, a tuning fork is like a metal fork that you can, make a sound with. Okay, so basta ibabangga nyo lang siya or parang hindi man ibabangga, pero like i-tap. Once you tap it to another solid, it can create a sound. So yung nakita nyo C, that is the compression wherein the particles are pushed together. Dahil nga gumalaw yung tuning fork, so gumalaw siya, yung part ng hangin dito, makukompress yung gas particles natin dito. Magkakasama. So since resounding yung ano, kumbaga when you have a tuning fork, parang gaganon-ganon siya, di ba? So parang gagalaw-galaw ng ganyan yung tawag dito, yung tuning fork natin. So kaya, mapupush niyo yung particles forward, tas since meron siyang pabalik pa, so mamamove din yung mga air particles natin. So kaya nagkakaroon din tayo ng compression and rarefaction. So that happens in air also. Okay? And so, yung darker areas again, that is the area wherein the particles are compressed together because of the pushing and pulling of the material. And then the rarefaction is the area that is lighter because the particles are farther apart. Okay, magkakahiwalay yung ating mga particles, kaya lighter. Ayan. So, syempre, parang isipin nyo na lang may slinky kasi wala kasi yung slinky dito sa bahay. Mag-search na lang kayo ng video. Ayan, nung sa slinky. Or if you have one at home, and then pag pinahaba nyo yan, tapos i-push and pull nyo siya, magkakaroon din kayo na makita na rarefactions and compressions. Okay? Ayan. So now let's go to the different factors affecting the speed of sound. So ngayon, since ang sound kasi, it travels at different speeds because of the medium wherein it's going to travel. So that's why it is affected whenever the medium is exposed to different factors. Okay, so first, let's go to the medium. So sound travels faster in an object with more compact particles. So ang nangyari kasi dyan, pag mas malapit yung mga particles sa isa't isa, yung vibration is madaling maipasa sa susunod na particle. Okay? Kasi mas malapit sila or mas compact sa isa't isa. So isipin nyo na lang kung nasa ano kayo, tren or sa MRT, LRT. kung siguro sa old normal natin, di ba, kapag nakasakay kayo sa LRT, gumalaw lang yung isang tao papunta dun sa may pintuan, mararamdaman nyo, di ba? So kasi magkakalapit kayo sa isa't isa, lalo na kapag rush hour, di ba? So pag rush hour, magkakalapit yung mga tao, tapos pag may dadaan, mararamdaman nyo. So kumbaga magsishift din kayo ng position nyo para maka-accommodate dun sa taong dumadaan, di ba? So, ganun lang din yun. Kapag mas malalapit yung particle sa isa't isa, mas mabilis mag-travel yung sound. So, ayan ha, may clue na kayo dun sa activity na gagawin nyo. Okay? Next, let's go to the second factor, which is air density. So, in this one, we'll be talking about gaseous medium. Okay, so sound travels faster in areas with a higher air density. So, especially in lower altitudes. So, if you recall that in Earth, once you go higher and higher in altitude, the air is thinner. Diba? Parang sinasabi na may manipis na hangin. Diba? Or kapag, siguro for those who have traveled on higher areas or for those who have, for those who experience mountain climbing, diba, it's harder to breathe when you are at a higher altitude. So, kumbaga, parang ang bilis nyong hingalin kapag nasa medyo tuktok na kayo, di ba? So, in areas that are higher, there is a lower air density. Kasi, di ba, kapag pataas tayo ng pataas, di ba, panipis ng panipis yung ating hangin, di ba? So, kasi yung air particles natin, mas naiipon siya sa baba. Kasi, di ba, ayun nga, we need air sa baba. At since, di ba, ano tawag dito, pag nandun na tayo sa outer space, wala namang masyadong gaseous particles doon. So, yun. Anyway, so, kumbaga, isipin nyo na lang na mas naririnig kayo kapag nandito kayo sa mababang altitude. So, kunwari, pag sumigaw kayo sa tuktok ng bundok, kumbaga, mas mahihirapan yung sinisigawan nyo na marinig ka. Bakit? When we talk about density, we're also talking about the compactness of the particles. So, at lower areas, the particles are closer together. That's why it's easier to transfer the sound. But in high altitude areas with a lower air density, it is harder for the vibration to travel because the particles are a bit farther apart. Okay? Clear na ba tayo sa air density? And so since video naman to, pwede nyo nang i-playback eh. Pag may hindi kayo na-gets. Anyway. And so next, we have our third factor, which is elasticity. So, I would like to recall first a definition of elasticity. So, elasticity is the ability of an object to go back to its own shape after being exerted by a certain force or a pressure. Okay, so yung high elasticity materials natin, yun yung mga rigid materials natin kasi kapag nag-exert ka ng pressure sa kanila, hindi siya masyadong nade-deform. Okay? So, it says here that sound travels faster in elastic materials since particles are closer together. For high elasticity materials, the particles are closer together. That's why they don't deform easily. Okay? So, that's why siguro sa solids natin ito mas maganda ma-relate. So, kunwari, meron tayong metal tsaka rubber. Diba? So, kapag nag-tap ka sa isang side ng metal, parang ang bilis mong marinig yung sound kapag nasa kabilang ibayo ka. Diba? Pero, kasi, diba, yung metal kasi, hindi siya easily deformed. So, that is a highly elastic material. When you use a rubber, diba yung rubber, nasa-stretch siya. So, medyo nade-deform siya, pero bumabalik pa rin siya sa original configuration or itsura niya. So, since ang rubber ay mas nade-deform compared sa metal, so, kumbaga, mas mas magkakahiwalay yung particles natin kasi nade-deform siya. Okay? Pag nade-deform kasi medyo bumibitaw pero bumabalik naman yung particles near to each other. Pero since nga nade-deform siya, lower yung elasticity niya, so kaya mas mabagal yung sound kapag mga ganong klaseng materials yung ginamit natin, like rubber. Okay? Because yung rubber, low yung elasticity niya, so compared sa metal. Okay, yung metal kasi mas rigid siya, so mas mataas yung resistance niya to deform once exerted by pressure. So that's why sound travels faster in highly elastic materials because the particles are closer together. Okay, so kumbaga kahit na, kumbaga isipin nyo na lang, ito yung mga taong magkakasangga, tapos kahit na anong pressure yung i-ano sa kanila, hindi sila basta-basta bumibitaw yung particles natin. Kasi kapag lower yung elasticity, medyo bumibitaw sila, pero hindi naman totally bumibitaw. Okay? Ayan. So, gets ba yung sa elasticity? And lastly, we have temperature. So, sound travels faster in higher temperatures because of its increased kinetic energy of particles. So, marirelate natin siya sa heat and temperature. Ayan. So, bale, di ba kapag mas mainit, isipin nyo na lang yung sarili nyo, kapag nasa mas mainit na lugar kayo, tapos you are barefoot and then you are exposed in solid pavement na walang bubong, are you going to stay there in the middle? Nahahayaan nyo lang bang mapaso yung paa mo? Di ba hindi? So, ganun lang din sa mga particles natin. So, they will not stay still once they are exposed to a high temperature. Okay? So, kapag meron tayong higher temperature, napapagalaw yung particles. So, when the particles move, there is an increase in the kinetic energy. If you recall again our lecture about kinetic energy, so that is the energy of objects that are moving. In this case, smaller object, which is the particle. So, once that particle gets a high kinetic energy, then it's going to move faster. So, since magalaw or malikot yung particle natin, so mataas yung chances na makabunggo or makaroon siya na makasalubong niya yung susunod na particle na magalaw din. Okay? So, since magalaw sila, mabilis na ta-transfer yung vibration from one particle to another with the aid of the movement of the particles. Kasi nga, mas malikot siya, mas gumagalaw siya, so yung vibration nito, mas madaling natatransfer dito kasi gumagalaw nga sila. Okay, so kaya kapag mas mainit, mas mabilis mag-travel yung sound compared sa mga lugar kung saan mas malamig. Diba? So imagine ninyo, diba pag sa mga movies, merong nasa stranded, sa snowstorm, diba? So parang ang hirap marinig yung call for help kasi mabagal gumalaw yung particles kasi nga malamig. Di ba pag malamig, hindi masyadong gumagalaw yung particles. Parang tayo lang din. Pag malamig, di ba ang sarap matulog, ang sarap wag gumalaw sa bahay, ang sarap na magstay lang sa kama, nakakatamad. So, ganun lang din yung particles natin. So, tinatamad din sila kapag malamig. Ayan. So, kaya hindi ganun kabilis mag-travel yung sound kasi mabagal. Okay? So, clear na ba tayo dito sa apat na factors affecting the speed of sound? And if it's not clear, you can just go back, replay some of my explanation. Or you can read in your textbook or you can search in the internet. Now, next we're going to focus on temperature. How temperature in air. So, ito, mas magpo-focus tayo ngayon sa air tsaka sa temperature. Okay, so this this equation is how we can compute for the speed of sound at a given temperature. Okay, so it is Vt. Yan equals 332 meter per second plus 0.6 meter per second per degree Celsius times temperature in degree Celsius. So ano nga, explain ko muna to ha. So yung 332 meter per second, that is the speed of sound in, sorry, speed of sound in air at a temperature of 0 degrees Celsius. Again, take note. 332 meter per second, that is the speed of sound in air at a temperature of 0 degrees Celsius. And the one that you can see inside the parentheses, that is the rate at which the speed increases. So, kada isang degrees Celsius na dagdag ng temperature natin, 0.6 yung ia-add natin dun sa 332 meters per second. So, kumbaga, kapag tumaas ng 2 degrees Celsius yung ating temperature, mag-a-add tayo ng 2 0.6 meter per second dun sa 332 meter per second. Don't worry, we have a sample problem wherein I will show you how to compute for this one. So, bale, huwag kayong malilito dito, ha? Una, mumultiply nyo muna yung temperature in degrees Celsius sa 0.6, tapos saka nyo siya i-add sa 332. Okay, clear ba yun? Yan. So, now let's have our first sample problem. Yan. Okay. So, at an atmospheric temperature of 40 degrees Celsius, what is the speed of sound in air? So, meron tayong given. Yeah. So, first, let's write the given. Our given is a temperature or TC in degrees Celsius of 40 degrees Celsius. And then, we are required to find VT. Okay, velocity, the speed of sound at a certain temperature. So our equation is we have Vt equals 332 meter per second plus 0.6 meter per second all over degrees Celsius times Tc. Okay, then for our solution, we'll just substitute it. So, let's have 332 meter per second plus and 0.6 meter per second over degrees Celsius. Ay, sorry. Ayan. Tapos, yung TC natin, let us substitute that. So, we have 40 degrees Celsius. So, again, let's multiply it first. So, continuation of VT. So, 332 meter per second plus, let's multiply it. So, we have 0.6 times 40. Ayan, so we have 24. Ayan, makakancel yung degree Celsius dito ha, kasi mumultiply niyo itong dalawa sa isa't isa. So, we have 24 meter per second and then we're going to add that. So, for our final answer, we have 332 plus 24, we have 356. Anong unit ng speed? Meter per second. Okay? Ayan. So, clear na ba tayo dito? Okay. So, wait, clear natin. Yan. Okay. Next, for sample problem number 2. For this one, medyo mag-derive tayo. And so, what is the temperature of air where sound is traveling at 346 meter per second? So, this time, we're going to look for the temperature and not the speed of air. So, what we're going to do is we're somehow going to manipulate the equation so that we can solve for TC. Okay? Sana yung, ay, hindi pa pala ako naka-annotate. Ayan. Again, so let's solve this one. So, we have a given here, which is we have VT of 346 meter per second. And then, we are required to find for the temperature. at degrees Celsius. Degrees Celsius lang ako natin dito. And then for our equation, we have Vt equals 332 meter per second plus 0.6 meter per second all over degrees Celsius times Tc. So ngayon, we'll solve for Tc. So first, tanggalin muna natin yung iba. So itong 332, we'll transpose it to the other side. So we have Vt minus 332 meter per second equals 0.6 meter per second divided by degrees Celsius times Tc. So, so that we can remove 0.6 to Tc, let's divide both sides by this one. Okay? So, divide natin both sides by 0.6 meter per second per degrees Celsius. And so, itong kabila din. 0.6 meter per second per degree Celsius. Yeah, so maka-cancel to. So we will be left with an equation of Tc is equals to Vt minus 332 meter per second divided by 0.6 meter per second divided by degree Celsius. Okay? So balikan nyo na lang, pero i-playback nyo na lang pag may na-miss kayo dun sa explanation. So now let's go to the solution part. Lagyan muna natin ang harang to para hindi magkagalo. And so for the solution, we're going to substitute here. So we have Tc is equals to Vt, which is 346. 346 meter per second minus, yan, 332. Meter per second divided by 0.6 meter per second divided by degrees Celsius. So, for this one, we're going to divide first the numerator. Then after that, we'll be dividing it by 0.6. Okay? So, 346 minus 332. We'll have 14, and so 14 meter per second divided by 0.6 meter per second divided by degrees Celsius. So, ang mangyayari dito kasi yung degrees Celsius, mapupunta siya sa denominator. Ay, mapupunta siya sa numerator. Okay? Kasi pag nag-divide tayo ng fraction, tapos may fraction sa denominator, kukunin natin yung reciprocal. So, ito na nga. Ipapakita ko na sa inyo. Ayan. So, meron tayong 14 meter per second. Tapos, ang reciprocal nitong nitong unit na to is wait lang. Ayan. So, iwan natin yung wait. So, ihiwalay na lang natin yung units natin kasi pag sinama pa natin. And so, bale, dito, magkakaroon tayo ng meter per second times reciprocal ng meter per second divided by degree Celsius. So, punta sa baba yan. Kasi degree Celsius nasa taas. So, maka-cancel yan. So, kaya matitira natin unit dito ay degree Celsius. Okay? So, ito lang yung explanation nung sa... Pero as is natin na i-divide yung 14 tsaka 0.6. Okay? So, for our final answer, so 14 divided by 0.6, we will get a temperature of 23.33 degrees Celsius. Okay? Ayan. So, yan ang ating final answer. So, the temperature of air where the speed of sound is 346 meter per second is 23.33 degrees Celsius. So, yun yung temperature niya. Okay? Ayan. So, I'll clear this one. And then let's go to the last part of our lecture. Ayan. So, bakit ko ito ipapakita sa inyo? Because this is just a recall of your grade 7, kung nakaabot man kayo dito. And so, we'll, whatever medium, solid man yan, liquid man yan, or gas man yan, the relationship between speed, frequency, and wavelength is the same. So, ang mangyari kasi dyan is yung sound natin, yung nakikita nyo na 332 meters per second, that is the speed of sound. That is also the speed of sound waves, kasi waves din yung sound natin. So, we have here lambda, which is the wavelength of the sound. T is the period wherein it travels. And then, as you can see on the right side, we have F equals 1 over T. And so, that is just the frequency in hertz. So, to get the frequency, you'll just get the reciprocal of the period. Okay? So, paano nga ba natin masasagutan yan? Okay, so for example, ayan, wait lang. So, mag-new share tayo ng whiteboard. Ayan. Okay, so sulat ko lang uli yung ating equation. Hello. Ayan, so, V, nangyari sa, hello, graphic tablet, gumana ka. Ayan, gumana na siya ulit. Okay, so I'll just write our equation first. V is equals to lambda over T and F equals 1 over T. So kung meron tayong speed dito, tawag dito, wavelength, T, tsaka F. Ayan. So kunwari may table tayo ng mga values. Ay, then hindi to with mag-drawing si Miss. Ayan. So, kunwari, meron tayong speed na 95 meters per second. Okay, so, tas meron tayong period na 8 seconds. So, paano natin makukuha si lambda or wavelength in meters and si frequency in hertz? So, syempre, may triangle tayo dito. Ayan, so, kung natatandaan nyo pa yung triangle sa science. Ito yung gagamitin nyo. So, dito yung speed, ito yung wavelength, ito yung period. Tapos para sa frequency and period. And so, ito yung frequency, ito yung number one. Tapos ito yung period. Okay? So, isa lang tong ibibigay ko ha. Ayan. So, paano natin makukuha yung wavelength? So, let's look at the triangle at the top. So, meron tayong we have a vertical line between V and T. So, it means we're going to multiply. So, 95 times 8, we will get 760 meters. Okay? Kasi meters yung wavelength natin. E, paano naman si frequency? So, we'll use the one at the bottom. Ayan, yung... Yan. So, 1 and T is separated by a horizontal line. So, we're going to divide it. So, we have 1 divided by 8. So, we will get 0.125 hertz. Yan. Okay? So, ganun-ganun lang din yan. Paano naman kapag given yung... So, kumbaga ano, ayan, easy recall lang naman yan nito. Okay? So, yan. Okay. Ayan. So, this ends our discussion. And so, just answer what I've asked you to answer. Yung nasa quick quiz 4-2. Ata, ayun. So, at pag nag-discuss tayo next week, sasabihin ko kung paano makuha yung mga sagot. Okay? So, yun lang. Okay, so goodbye. And I'll see you on Monday. Or Tuesday kung Prophet Amos. Okay, bye.